Namaste. Welcome to the Preeti Experience. This is Preeti Upala. Our topic for this week is the spiritual transformation of our time. We are living in interesting times indeed. Perhaps the most challenging, perplexing, and fearful time ever in our history. We are in the twilight zone in many ways. The COVID-19 pandemic has affected our planet like nothing else ever has until this moment. Just goes to show that no matter how rich, how successful, or how powerful you are, you may be living in the greatest country in the world at the best time in history, and yet our entire existence is at stake, and with our every move now controlled by a force beyond us. If anything, COVID-19 has taught us everything we were doing wrong in our lives. Let's explore the success of this free, technologically advanced world that we live in today. The Western society especially, which is known as a template for a free and equal society, focuses more on success and achievement, yet perhaps less on inner fulfillment and genuine contentment. We are more connected than ever before, and yet more depressed, sick, and lonelier than ever as well. We are so disconnected from Mother Nature, from each other, and even our higher self in the deepest sense. Perhaps we took our world and each other for granted, did not ask the right questions or look in the right places for answers. Maybe we were not living our best self or chasing our authentic dharma, purpose in life. We are now being shown a mirror to evaluate ourselves honestly and take a deeper look within. Hollywood in particular is La La Land after all. This is the most illusory town in the world, and we are realizing just how consumed we had become in the meaningless and the material. In the Western society, we are unfortunately not equipped to deal with deep, complex maladies such as depression or loneliness. We are not encouraged to seek help, especially with alternative remedies and metaphysical modalities. Young or old, people are not encouraged to get help or explore other possibilities and different ways of being. We are not asking the right questions or looking for answers in the right places or seeking advice from the right people. I do not believe we are focusing on what's truly important in life. But why is this the case? In the end, the only thing that matters is the divine connection you can have with your true self and indeed the divine itself. That alone can fill the heart with unconditional love and fill the void inside. That alone can keep these maladies at bay. In Sanatan Dharma, or Hinduism as it's commonly known, a fundamental spiritual principle is that life is just a leela. Life is just a divine play. We are all just actors here, playing our parts, reading our lines, and fulfilling our samskaras, our karmic patterns. Everything is maya. Maya is a divine illusion. The only thing real is our soul and its journey. The oldest spiritual and indeed scientific text in the world, the Vedas, dating at least 5,000 years, if not more, talk about these profound concepts of interconnectedness and oneness. Perhaps we could find some solace in this ancient wisdom to make some sense of it all. The solution may be a cultural one. The West could benefit enormously from looking to the East, especially during this time, for its hierarchy of values. In India, for example, Hindus accept the impermanence of everything material and understand that the only thing that is of any importance or consequence is to move towards moksha or spiritual liberation. Seeking the truth is the highest goal in Hindu culture. In India, even the poorest have this understanding and surrender to the divine flow of life. And you can see this in the glimmer in their eyes and their warm smiles. Some of them have an inner peace you would struggle to find even in some of the most wealthiest cities in the world. All these lessons are more resonant now than ever. They give us an opportune moment to look within and contemplate. It is the perfect time to truly meditate. California has always been a place where there is a yoga studio or a meditation center on every corner. But can we practice without these physical centers? This is the true test of our sadhana, our spiritual practice, to test if we have indeed been practicing what we have been preaching. Self-love and self-compassion come from knowing that you are not the mind or the body, but the spirit that resides within. When you honor that spirit inside as divinity and know that it is connected to the universal consciousness, only then will you revere your own life and the lives of others. On the one hand, we are more unified and interconnected due to the global lockdown. And yet on the other, life is teaching us now that we are ultimately traveling solo on this journey of our spiritual path. There have also been a lot of people globally who have transitioned during this time. Some public figures and many who are not. We are being shown the cycle of life, the samsara, the cycle of birth and death. The only things that give solace to our soul is that it is all divinely perfect. This seems to be an alarming problem in the Western world, and hopefully we can find the courage to find this solace in our soul's desire. It may be looking east or maybe looking within, but we are realizing that people need compassion, they need understanding, and most of all, they need love. And that interestingly, we can even get it during the seemingly most defeated times. The silver lining in all of this is the clean air, the clean ocean, the rejuvenated nature, and a replenished planet. This is ultimately a great thing, a reset, a global reset. This is something we have been wanting for a while, and now it has magically arrived. It's important in these crucial times to hang on to everything good and not to relapse in the near future. The human spirit is strong and unwavering in the face of adversity and fear. We are going through yet another test of our spirit and yet have the conviction that we will be all right. I am an eternal optimist and have no doubt that this too shall pass. Thank you for listening. Namaste.